Jennings High School welcomes you to our production of Into the Woods Junior. Remember, there is no cell phone reception in these woods, so please turn your cell phones off to save your battery. Please keep in mind that you may encounter strange objects, witches, and wolves. No matter how strange, we ask that you refrain from any photography during the show. Now sit back, relax, and enjoy our show.
Once upon a time, a witch in a far-off kingdom, more than anything,
lived a young lady's
life,
more than jewels,
a fabulous laugh, and a childless baker.
I wish
more than anything,
more than the moon.
I wish
the king could sit in the festival.
More than life,
I wish to go to the festival.
More than riches,
I wish my cow would give us some milk.
More than anything,
I wish we had a child.
I want a child.
I wish.
You wish to go to the festival?
The poor girl's mother had died.
You wish to go to the festival? The festival? The king's festival?
And her father had taken in for his new wife, a woman with 2 daughters of her own. All three were beautiful of face, but vile and black of heart.
Why, come in, little girl.
I wish. It's not for me, it's for my granny in the woods. A loaf of bread, please. To bring my poor old hungry granny in the woods. Just a loaf of bread, please. Thank you. Into the woods, it's time to go. I hate to leave, I have to go. Into the woods, it's time, and so I have to take the journey. Into the woods and through the trees to where I am exactly there. Into the woods to grandma's house.
Are you certain of your way?
The light is clear, the light is good. I have no fear, nor no one should. The woods are just trees, the trees are just wood. I sort of hate to ask you, but do you have a basket?
Here, just don't stray if you wait.
And his mother, a witch, well, she was not quite beautiful. A witch with soft and not a hole. A witch with house were not a mess. I wish the cows were milk. I wish the wolves were fun. I wish a lot of things.
Listen well, son. Milky White must be taken to market.
But mother, no, he's the best cow.
She's given us no food and no milk for a week. We've no money and no choice but to sell her.
And Milky White is my best friend in the entire world.
Look at her. Son, take no less than 5 pounds. Are you listening to me?
Yes, no more than 5 pounds.
Less than 5. Now go!
Because the baker had lost his mother and father in a baking accident, well, at least that's what he believed, he was eager to start a family of his own and was worried until now that all efforts had failed.
It's the witch from next door.
The old enchantress told the couple she had placed a spell on their house.
What spell?
In the past, when your mother was with child, she developed an unusual appetite. She took one look at my beautiful garden and told your father what she wanted more than anything in the world. Was greens, greens, and nothing but greens. Parsley, peppers, cabbages, and celery, asparagus, and watercress, and fennel, and lettuce, he said, all right. But it wasn't quite, because I caught him in the autumn in my garden one night. He was robbing me, harassing me, rooting through my rutabaga, raiding my arugula, and gripping up my granny, my champion, my baby. But I let him have the ramping and I lots to spare in return. However, at the fair is fair, you will let me have the baby that your wife will bear. And you call it square.
You mean I had a brother?
No, but you had a sister. But the witch refused to tell him any more about her sister, not even that her name was Rapunzel. You know, I thought I had been more than reasonable, but how was I supposed to know what your father had hidden in his pocket?
What?
Beans.
Beans?
The special beans. I left no, I didn't know he'd stolen my beans. I was watching him crawl back over the wall and then bang, crash, and the lightning flash, and well, that's another story. Anyway, at last the big day came, and I made my claim. Oh no, take away the baby, they shrieked and shrieked, but I did, and I hit her, but she'll never be me. And your father cried, and your mother died, and for extra measure, I'll admit it was a pleasure, and I'm sorry, I'm super mollified. And I laid a little spell on him. You too, son. That your family tree would always be a barren one. No more fuss and there's no more seeds and my garden thrives. See my nectarines, but I'm telling you to save myself kings and queens. Don't ever, never, ever miss a rubber my dream. Especially with
then the witch, for purposes of her own, explained how the baker might lift his spell.
Have the curse reversed, thou need a certain potion first. Go to the woods and bring me back. One, the cow is white as milk. Two, the cape is red as blood. Three, the hair is yellow as corn. Four, the slipper is pure as gold. Bring me these before the chime of midnight. And in 3 days' time you shall have, I guarantee, a child as perfect as child can be. Go to the wood.
Ladies, our parents
wait. Please may I go to the festival?
The festival? The festival is one of my friends. The carriage is waiting. We must be going.
I wish.
I found your father's hunting gear.
Six beans!
Could they be?
The witch's beans! We can take them with us!
No, you are not to come and that is fine. Now, what might you return with?
You don't remember? The cow is white as milk, the cape is red as blood, the hair is yellow as corn, the slipper is pure as gold.
The cow is white as milk,
and so the baker reluctantly set off to meet the owner's wish.
Corn, the slipper is pure as gold.
After Cinderella,
but how am I ever to get to the festival? I know all maids and fathers pay the girl the handle tree and tell her to put you go to the king festival. Into the woods without regret, the choice is made, the task is set. Into the woods but not forgetting why I'm on the journey. Into the woods to get my wish, I don't care how the time is now. Into the woods to lift the spell.
Make the potion.
Go to the festival. Into the woods to grandmother's house. Into the woods to grandmother's house. The light is clear. The light is good. I have no fear, nor no one should. The woods are just trees. The trees are just wood. No need to be afraid there.
There's something in the glade there.
Worth the journey.
Into the woods to see the king,
sell the cow. To make the potion, to see, to sell, to get, to bring, to make, to lift, to go to the festival. Into the woods, into the woods, into the woods, and out of the woods. And all the floors
grandmother. She visited there so often and wept so much that her tears watered it.
until I've grown to a handsome tree.
I wish.
What child specified? Opportunity is not a lengthy visitor.
I wish.
Do you know what you wish? Are you certain what you wish is what you want? Ask the tree. And you shall have your wish. Quiver and quiver, little tree. Silver and gold rain down on me. I'm off to get my wish.
Silence everywhere, Milky Way. Not to my liking.
Hello, Jack.
How do you know my name?
How much are you asking for the animal?
No less than 5 pounds, sir.
Why, you'd be looking sulfur for a sack of beans.
Come along, Milky Way. There are spirits here.
Good day, young lady.
Good day, Mr. Wolf.
Whither away so hurriedly?
To my grandmother.
And what might be in your basket?
Bread and wine, so grandmother will have something good to make her strong.
And where might your grandmother live?
Further in the woods. Her house stands under large oak trees.
Hello, little girl, what's your rush? You're missing all the flowers. The sun won't set for hours. Take your time.
Mother said, sugar and not worry.
But slow, little girl, hark and hush. The birds are singing sweetly. The birds completely. You're traveling so fleetly.
Mother said not to stray, so I suppose it's no delay. Bring my mother fresh today. Goodbye, Mr. Wolf.
Goodbye, little girl. Harm to come to that little girl in the red cape.
Oh, forget the little girl and get the cape!
How am I supposed to get it?
The little thing. And just take it! Eat it.
I'll never get that golden cow, or yellow slipper, or red hair. No, that's not right.
The cow is white as milk, the cape is red as blood, the hair is yellow as corn, the slipper is
blue. What are you doing here?
I wish to help. Please.
You have no business being alone in the wood.
But please, I'm just trying to be helpful.
No, you don't need to be.
We need to do this together.
No.
A cow as white as milk.
Hello there, young lad. What might you be doing with a cow in the middle of the woods?
Heading to the market. But I seem to have lost my way.
What do you plan on doing there?
Oh, and what do you plan on doing once you get there?
Sell my cow, sir. No less than 5 pounds.
5 pounds?
Well,
What are you to do if you can't fetch that sum?
I suppose my mother and I will have no food to eat.
Beans! No, no, we mustn't give up our beans. Well, if you insist that we must. Beans will bring you food, son.
Beans in exchange for my cow?
They're no ordinary beans. These beans... Oh, they carry magic!
Magic? What kind of magic?
Tell them!
Well, it's magic that defies description.
You'd be lucky to sell her for a sack of beans.
How many beans?
Six.
No, five. We can't part with all of them. And besides, I'd say they're worth a pound each at the very least.
Well, could I buy my cow back someday?
Oh, possibly. Good luck there, young lad.
I guess this is goodbye, old pal. You've been a perfect friend. I need to see us part, old pal. So then I'll buy you back. I'll see you soon again.
I was just trying to be helpful.
Magic beans? Are we to dispel this curse through deceit?
If you know what you want, then you go and you find it and get it.
Home.
Do we want a child or not? And you give and you take, or you beg, or you bargain, or you live to regret it.
Will you please go home?
There are rights and wrongs and in between. No one works with more to intervene.
Please, take the cow and go home. I would carry this out in my own fashion.
If Saltmaker continued his search, the cape is red as blood.
Wonderful red cape.
My granny made it for me.
Really? I would love to have one for myself.
You'd look pretty foolish.
May I see it?
I don't like to be without my cape. Please don't grab it.
Oh, forget the little girl and get the cape!
I'm so sorry. I just want to make sure you really love that cape. Now, you be safe out there and make sure no wolves come your way.
I'd rather a wolf than you any day.
If you know what you need, then you go and you find it and you take it. Do I want a child or not? Things are only what you need them for. What's important is who needs them more. I need that cape.
Until the beggar with newfound determination went after the red cape. As for the little girl, she was surprised to see her grandmother's cottage door standing open.
Good day, Grandmother. My Grandmother, You're looking awfully strange. What big ears you have?
But I don't hear you, Mrs. Monkey.
But Grandmother, what big eyes you have?
The badger see you, Mrs. Monkey.
Oh, Grandmother, what a terrible big wet mouth you have.
The bird to eat you with.
With the wolf's appetite for peas, he took to bed a nice long nap.
Hi. My grandmother does have a mighty snore. Hi. Where is the little one? Grandmother. Ha! Seems to be that little piece of fabric in the corner of your mouth. I know. You must get that cake from within your stomach.
What a fright! How dark and dank it was inside that wolf!
Kill the devil!
Granny! Quiet, child! This evil must be destroyed!
Well, I'll leave you two to your task.
Well, do you want the skins?
No, thank you.
Well, what kind of hunter are you?
I'm a baker.
Mother said, should have been natural or been misled. I should have heeded her advice, but he seemed so nice. And he showed me things, many beautiful things that I hadn't thought to explore. They were on my path, so I never had dared. I've been so careful, I never had cared. When he said, come in, with that sickening grin, how could I know what was in store? Once his teeth were bare, then I really got scared, well, excited and scared. But he drew me close and he swallowed me down, down the dark, slimy path, with a secret that I never wanted to know. But I know things now, many valuable things that I hadn't known before. Do not put your faith in a cape and a hood. They will not protect you the way that they should. And take extra care with strangers. Even flowers have their dangers. And though scary is exciting, nice is different than good. Now I know, don't be scared. Granny's right, just keep it fair. It's meant to know a lot. And a little bit not.
Certain?
Yes, maybe Granny can make me a new one with the skins of that wolf.
Thank you.
And so the baker, with his second article in hand, feeling more braver and satisfied than he ever felt before, ran back through the woods. As for the lad Jack, little did they know, those beans would grow into an enormous beanstalk that would stretch into the heavens.
Have you seen a beautiful young maiden in a ball gown pass through?
I don't think so, sir. Royalty before. I never anything to royalty before.
Thank you.
What a beautiful ball gown you're wearing. Were you at the King's Festival?
Yes.
Aren't you the lucky one? If a prince were looking for me, I certainly wouldn't hide. Tell me about the ball.
It's a very nice ball.
Yes, and?
And they have far too much food.
Oh,
the prince.
Yes, the prince.
If he knew who I really was.
Oh? Who?
I'm afraid I was rude.
Oh? How?
Now I'm being pursued.
Yes, and?
I'm not in the mood.
Are you to return to the festival tomorrow week?
Perhaps.
Perhaps? be pursued by a prince. All that pursues me is tomorrow's bread. What I wouldn't give to be in your shoes.
Would you look at that? An enormous vine growing next to a little cottage.
I mean slippers.
It looks like a cherry beanstalk.
As Karen's gone,
I must get home.
No, I mean your shoe. Hey, come back here.
For a whole year. Buy a new thatched roof or new chimney or...
But could you buy yourself a child?
I'm sorry?
How badly do you wish a child? 5 gold pieces? 10? 20?
I've not thought to put a price on it.
Exactly! The money is not what's important. What's important is that your wish be honored.
Wait, no, come back!
You have the red cape!
Yes, we've only 2 objects left to go.
Well, 3.
2. I have the cape and you've the cow.
You've the cape!
What have you done with the cow?
She ran away from me. I never reached home. I've been looking for her all night.
I knew I shouldn't have entrusted her to you.
She could have just as easily run away from you.
But she didn't.
I'm sorry that I lost the cow.
I'm sorry. I shouldn't have yelled. Just please go back home. I will make this right. No more searching in the woods for strange objects. No more witches or dim-witted little boys or hungry little girls. Go!
There you are, good brother. Father and I have wondered where you gone.
I've been out all night, searching for her. The maiden that I danced the evening with.
Where did she go?
Disappeared.
Well, I too have found a lovely maiden. She lives at the top of a tall tower that has no door or stairs.
And how do you manage a visit?
I stand beneath her tower and I say, Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair to me. And she lowers the longest, most beautiful head of hair, as yellow as corn, which I climb to her.
Rapunzel. What kind of name is that? You jest.
She is as true as your maiden. A maiden running from a prince? Does that make sense? None would run from us.
And yet, one has. Did I abuse her or show her disdain? Why does she run from me?
If I should lose her, how shall I regain the heart she has won from me? Agony beyond power of speech, when the one thing you want is the only thing out of your reach. High in her tower, she sits by the hour, maintaining her hair. Blind and becoming, and frequently humming a light-hearted air. Agony, far more painful than yours, when you know she would go with you if there only were doors. Agony, oh, the tortures they teach. Always 10 steps behind, always 10 feet below, and she's just out of reach. Agony, that can cut like a knife. I must have her to wife.
Two princes, each one more handsome than the other. I need to get that hair.
Excuse me, young woman. Have you encountered a young boy answering to the name of Jack?
Not the one partial to a white cow?
He's the one.
Have you seen the cow?
No, and I don't care to ever again.
I'm sorry. I haven't seen your son today, ma'am.
You better not have gone off that beanstalk again.
Jack! Jack! Jack!
Moo! Looking for your cow?
Yes. Where did you find it?
Hello?
What are you doing?
I'm here to make amends.
You've caused enough trouble, man.
I'm here to see your wish be granted.
I want you to stay out of this. Go!
You've changed your daring.
your difference in the woods. More show, more sharing, you're getting us through the woods. If you could see your mother where I started, and much more of it was in than I knew it to be.
It takes two. I thought one was enough. It's not true. It takes two of us who came through. When the journey was rough, it took you. It took two of us. It takes care. It takes patience and fear and despair to change. Though you swear to change, you can tell if you do. It takes two.
We change. Witches and slippers and hoods, just the two of us beyond lies. Safe at home with our beautiful prize. Just a few of us, it takes trust. It takes just a bit more and we're done. We want four, we had none, we got three. We need one, it takes two.
I never said you could take her back.
But you took the 5 gold pieces.
You took 5 gold pieces?
Hey, I didn't take, he gave.
You said I could have my cow.
You took them before a child?
Why?
Two midnights gone, and the exhausted baker and his wife buried the dead Milky White.
Will you please just go back to the village and get us a new cow?
How do you suppose I purchased this new cow?
Here. Tell them it's magic.
No one with the brain, the size of this, is going to exchange a cow for a bean!
And resent yourself to a childless life.
I feel it best you go to the village and search for a new cow, as I have met a maiden with a golden slipper these previous eves, and I think I just might obtain one.
Fine. That is simply fine.
Unfortunately for Rapunzel, the witch discovered her message for the prince before he could spear her way. Why didn't you tell me you had a visitor?
Because no man had that tower.
I gave you protection, and yet you disobeyed me.
I'm not a mere child. I wish to see the world.
Don't you know what's out there in the world? Someone has to shield you from the world.
Thank you.
Rapunzel to a remote desert, the witch came back to take the prince by surprise. As he leapt from the tower, the thorns in which she fell pierced his eyes and blinded him. As for Cinderella, she returned from a final visit to the festival.
He's a very smart prince. He's a prince who prepares. Knowing this time I'd run from him. He's heard pitch on the stairs. I was caught unawares. And I thought, well, he cares. This is more than just malice. Better stop and take stock. You're standing here stuck on the steps of the palace. Better run along home and avoid the collision. Even though they don't care, we'll be better off there. There's nothing to choose, there's nothing to lose. Do you cry out your shoes? Better out of the blue. And without any doubt, you know what your decision is, which is not to decide. You'll just leave him a clue. For example, a shoe. And then see what he'll do. Now it's he and not you who is stuck with a shoe. In a zoo. In the new. And you've learned something too. Something you never knew. On the steps of the palace.
Come to a happy end.
Shut up, old man!
Just listen to him. He's obviously a spirit of some sort. And besides, we only need one. Tomorrow's search for the medicine.
Doesn't anybody care if there's a dead giant in my backyard?
You bought the objects?
Yes.
This cow doesn't look as white as milk to me.
Oh, she is. She is.
This cow has been covered in flour.
Well, we did have a cow as white as milk. Honestly, we did.
Then where is she?
She's dead.
Kind of thought you'd prefer a live cow?
Of course I'd prefer a live cow, so go give me the dead one and I'll bring it back to life.
You can do that?
Now!
Jack, there you are!
Mother, look, the most beautiful heart! You've stolen way too much, son. Shame on you!
She's too heavy!
What's happening? Milky White! Now I have my friend back and I'm rich!
Quiet! Quickly, feed the objects to the cow.
What?
You heard me. Feed them to the cow.
Oh.
handle this.
I'll do it. So long you look for me. Squeeze, pal.
Wrong ingredients.
No!
Forget about a child.
No, we followed your instructions. One, the cow is as white as milk. Cake. Two, the cape was certainly as red as blood. Three, the slipper was gold.
And four, I compared the color of the hair to the color of the corn.
Yes, I pulled the hair from a maiden in a tower.
You what? No. I touched that hair. You don't understand, I can't have touched the ingredients.
The corn.
What?
The silky hair of the corn, pulled from the ear and feet of the cow. Quickly.
I swear to God, old man, this better work, but your son will be the last of your blood.
Son?
Not now.
Yes, it's your dad.
Father, but you died in a pig accident.
I didn't mean to run away, but she gave me no choice.
I don't understand.
Please, not now. Into the cup.
It's working! Milking!
Try to be still, turn off the
see the peculiar way of attracting a sparkle of sunshine like a magnet needs a world.
The girl obeyed, swallowing her pain. But once again, the prince noticed blood trickling from the shoe. And when Cinderella presented herself, the shoe fit like a glove.
This is the true bride.
Good. Yeah.
All right. You know, they got...